Measuring the flow of pupils through the education system. Do you normally have a way we measure the flow of pupils through educational system? And there are three possibilities of such measurement. One is through promotion. Two is through repeating the present grade, and thirdly, dropout. These are the three possibilities. When a student is admitted or enrolled in a particular grade within a level, to move from one grade to the other, three possibilities are likely to happen. It's either the student is promoted, or the student fails the class, is asked to repeat, or the student drops out. But these three possibilities are vital when you are calculating the efficiency of an educational system and when you want to determine the cost of wastages. But in this regard, we're going to stop on how you can calculate the promotion, repetition, and dropout rate. So let's look at this example. So assume enrollment in public primary school education in Nigeria by grade for 2013, 2014, and 2014, 2015. So right here, we'll have our figures that have been given by grade from primary 1 to primary 6. And from 2013, 2014, we have the enrollment. 2014, 2015, we have the enrollment. And out of this enrollment here, we have, there is a remark that is reminding you that right here, we'll have repeaters. And these repeaters are coming from 2013, 2014. That implies that the figures you are seeing here as enrolled, they are not new. Not all of them are new in the class. And because not all of them are new in the class, you are going to remove the 22 away from this to get the actual total that enrolled, and 32 from here out of this to get the total number that came in as new students into that particular level. So therefore, for you to get the total number of students that came in fresh, you must subtract this 22 from 900,000, and that will give you the actual total that came in for that year. Then again, you're going to see some red arrows. These red arrows shows the trend of promotion, the trend of movement. Right here, you have 900,000 and in primary 1. By 2014, 2015, they have moved to primary 2. Not all of them moved. Out of the 900,000, we are told here that 878 moved, then 22 repeated. Because they are coming from here, they repeated the class. So only these people moved down here. So for you to get the actual number again, they are moved, because here out of 890,000, 32 are repeating. So you always subtract this from this to get the actual number that were promoted. Because right here, this will not give you the actual total of promotion. So underneath where we said notes, you could see that in 2013, 2014, that means after primary 6, only 545,013 graduated from primary 6. That is why this arrow is indicating that, showing you the total number that graduated from primary 6. Right here, you are asked to calculate the rate of promotion, repetition, and dropout for primary 1 to 6 for which year? 2013, 2014. So the calculation is going to appear thus. Right here, we'll have the promotion rate, number of people promoted to grade G plus 1 in year T plus 1 over total number of pupils in grade G in year T. So what is going to happen, if you go back to the table, you discover that we have subtracted to be able to get the actual number that actually got promotion. You subtract the repeaters from it, and that is why you have this. Subtract this from this and base it on the total number, and that gives you from level 1, primary 1 to primary 2, that will give you 94.1%. So you continue in that trend, you calculate the next level and you have 92.1%, you calculate the next one, 90.1%, the next will give you 81.5%, and you have 78.5%. Now, the area that you normally have challenge is when you get to the last level. When you get to the last level, remember we have been told the total number that graduated. So you base the total number that graduated over the total enrollment for primary 6, which is the last grade, and you multiply by 100. When you do that, you're going to see this. Remember that if you go through that table once more, you're going to see 545,013 as the total that graduated. So over the total enrollment that we have for primary 6 times 100, that will give you 17.8. So you see the rates at which they move from one level to the other. This is the promotion rate. This promotion rate will be later used for other calculation. Now, to calculate for the repetition rate, the formula says number of pupils repeaters in grade G in year T plus 1 over the total number of pupils in grade G in year T times 100. Right here again, we're going to start with the calculation of 2013-2014. And if you go back to look for the total number of those that we are repeating in 2013-2014, we'll have 25 of them. So it will be 25 over 900 times 100 over 1. And that will give you 2.8. You continue in that trend, you will have the percentages written out. Then the last part, again, like I did say, is usually a problematic to students. Right here, remember, we have been told the total number that actually graduates. So you pick the total number of repeaters over, again, you pick the total number of repeaters over the total number enrolled and multiply. So this shouldn't be a problem. So the last part is the dropout rate. Remember, we have said three possibilities are likely to happen. It's either the student is promoted, or the student is to repeat, or the student drops out. So we want to know the rate at which they drop out, the percentage rate at which they drop out. In this instance, we'll have number of pupils dropping out from grade G in year T, the total number of pupils in grade G in year T. So in this area, we're going to look at what you have, and for you to know the total number of dropouts, you are going to consider the total number of the actual promotees and the total number of repeaters. So when you add the total number of repeaters to the total number of those that are promoted, you subtract it from the total enrollment. It means what is left are those that drop out. Then you now multiply it by 100. So in this instance, we have an example here. We have 900,000 as those that were enrolled for that primary one, if you go to the table, and these were the total that were the actual new, because remember, we are calculating for 2013-2014. So any students that do not fall into this grade, that did not start the schooling within this year, is not part of this cohort. It's not part of the students we are calculating. When we say cohort, we mean a group of students that are moving at the same time, they came in at the same time, started schooling at the same time, and they will move in trend at the same time. That is a cohort. So right here, to calculate the cohort for 2013-2014, any other student that do not fall into that group must be eliminated. That is why you are subtracting the repeaters, because they are not part of the cohort for 2013-2014. So when that is done, you multiply, you have 3.6. You follow that same trend to get all others. Then when you get to the final one, which is year 6, we want to know the total number that now drop out from year 6. Again, you go back and look at the total number that we're given as graduated from year 6. When you pick that total number that graduated from year 6, and you pick the total number that actually enrolled, you have to subtract the graduate from this, and you follow the same trend, you will have 17.6. By this way, you would have gotten your rates, the rates you're going to use to compute the efficiency rate. So this is where we're going to stop as per that. So when you now go to the next level, all you need to do is to now put it in a proper shape. It appears in this table. You can see the next table. You see the promotion rate, repetition rate for each of the years. You see for year 1, year 2, year 3, year 4, year 5, year 6. These are the figures. So it's these figures you are now going to put together that we use for further calculation.